There are actually a number of questions about what happens to your connectome when you die.
Yes.
And this whole notion of is it something that immediately goes away, or is it something that can live on? I think it's sort of touching on this question of almost this soul question.
So that's another buzzword in a kind of phrase in the book where I say information is the new soul. You could quote me on that. I say it half in jest, but half seriously. So there are philosophical doctrines. So you may be familiar with materialism, the idea that the universe is a bunch of billiard balls bouncing around, obeying the laws of physics. And there's the doctrine of mechanism. La Mettrie, the French philosopher, was the first, I think, he wrote this book, The Man, the Machine, that we're a bunch of cells. Parts of the machine are cells. They're interacting with each other. Or the neurons that make up our brain. It's a complicated machine. But the transhumanists actually turn that on its head. They say, you are not your atoms. You are the pattern in which they are arranged. You are not your neurons, but you are the pattern of connections by which they are organized. And information in that pattern is, in some sense, a ghostly thing. There's a material instantiation, but the information itself can be transferred into some other form. Like, I can take the information in my laptop. Let's say that you were really mean and you chopped up my laptop, and I wanted to resurrect it. I could take that hard disk out, and I could move that information to another laptop. Right? So we've come, and that's the reason why some people are fascinated by transhumanism now, because of our familiarity with computer technology, backups of computers, we become familiar with the idea that information might be the soul. And what information would that be? The connectome. So that's the philosophical kind of idea that permeates the ending of the book. And if you think about it, all of our efforts to be immortal involve preserving information. If you have kids, you're passing on the information in your DNA, but also you're nurturing them. You're telling them to do things, so you're impressing information on their brains. There are people who write novels and songs to be famous. They're propagating their information, right? So all these effects, all these bids to be immortal are about preserving information about you. And so cryonics is in some sense the ultimate, preserving all of the information that's in my brain, in deep frozen at liquid nitrogen temperatures. Can I preserve that?